Now, let's take a look at how the BRVM is performing, Sheikh. I mean, last week we were talking about the effect that political instability would be having on the market. Looking at how it's performed this week, it started the week off on a bearish note. Yesterday it picked up. I mean, what really is driving market behavior for you, Sheikh?
Hi. The least that we can say is that the instability is not disturbing the market, because for the first time this year we have like the best performance of the year. And over the month we can see that the main indexes are already up. The BRVM 10 is up 16% and the BRVM composite is up 10%. So nothing is going wrong.
Right. I mean, and most traders seem to have that same bullish outlook that you do. But let's talk about Sonatel. I mean, and that's a stock that we've really seen driving performance, huge demand, up 16% month to date. Let's talk about the stock split coming up. We're hearing that it's coming up tomorrow. What should we expect, Sheikh?
Yes. So tomorrow we're going to see the first stock split of Sonatel. In a ratio of 1 for 10, and the market is really, really optimistic. And what we saw this month is a trading volume of over 4 billion just for the stock, and usually that's the volume for the whole market over a month. And so tomorrow is going to be the speed. Today the stock was trading at 140,000, so tomorrow the stock will be trading at 14,000, and that we're going to attract a lot of new investors because the stock will appear cheaper to them.
Right.
So we can expect a deep, sharp increase in the coming weeks.
Okay, but let's return our focus back to how the index is performing, Sheikh. And certainly I'm curious to know, for you, which sectors are your recommended picks at this time? I mean, certainly the finance sector looking quite good, like you said, Sonatel also a good performer. Which sectors are the recommended picks for you, Sheikh?
Okay, we have Sonatel that is going well, but it's not the best performance so far. So far we have four big cap stock that are doing very, very well. We have Solibra in Ivory Coast that is selling beverage and beers. We have CIE that is like energy provider, and we have a bank, Société Générale of Côte d'Ivoire, that is doing very well. So all of them are driving the market up this month.
What about ETI? I mean, I noticed that stock seems to be featuring a lot on the gainers list over at the BRVM. I mean, what are your thoughts on ETI as a pick?
I mean, ETI remains a mystery for most of us. It's like we have a great performance for the bank over the year, and even lately we had an increase in the capital of the bank, but the stock is not moving. It's stuck at around 37. Frank, we don't know why, but I know that the bank has very good fundamentals, but it doesn't reflect on the stock price.
Right, and I'm sure, Sheikh, that there's some undervalued and small cap stocks that we can also be looking at, or certainly as we go into we're coming to the end of Q4 now. And very quickly, I'd also love to get your outlook for the BRVM as we go into a new week.
Yeah, my secret list for undervalued stock all from the agriculture sectors, because we know the rubber price and the palm oil price are going down worldwide, but the company remains really strong, and maybe in 6 months, 1 year, we're going to see the real success of this. So we're talking about Palm CI that is doing palm oil, and we're talking about about SPHC that is doing rubber. So right now they're undervalued, they're trading well under their intrinsic value, and it's time to buy.
Right. And I mean, I just want to quickly get an update on you and what the political situation currently is in Cote d'Ivoire, and certainly how it is affecting investor sentiment. We know that it hasn't affected the markets, but certainly there was a lot of concern about the instability in the country, looking like the government is finally putting itself together, Sheikh.
Yes, they're coming together right now. They're coming along. And what we have is that we actually see economic recovery, and even the IMF has revised the GDP growth up to 8.5. So that's a lot. And we can see that the government efforts start to pay off.
Well, thanks so much.
It's really time to go and buy Ivory Coast stocks.